One.
Hi, everybody. It's Mark Messier, and you're listening to Blueshirt
on the Ground Show,
the number one Rangers podcast. Make sure you tune in to find out all the latest news. Let's go, Rangers.
Blueshirt on the Ground.
This is an unlawful gathering. This is an unlawful gathering. The truth is out there. The truth is out there.
This is the underground. This is new media. This is the underground. This is new media.
Ranger fans report the critical thinking hanger. Ranger fans report the critical thinking hanger.
And now here is the starting lineup for the New York Rangers. And now here is the starting lineup for the New York Rangers.
This is New York Rangers hockey. 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 This is New York Rangers hockey.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Studio 2, the Blue Shirt Underground Show with Jim and Eddie. Today is Tuesday. It is January 28th, the year 2020. My name is Jim, and on the other side of the window, over there, I got to point the opposite direction. There he is, the one and only Eddie Geik. Eddie, good evening, and how are you? The mirror universe.
Yes, I'm doing well. I'm well rested from the Rangers. I'm back. I got a little bit of restoration, a little bit of hope for the rest of the season, I think. Watch the All-Star game. I didn't watch the All-Star game, but I watched the skills competition. So I'm refreshed and revived. That we cover a sport that actually is very fun and kind of thinks out of the box and just is. I like it, Jim. I'm doing good. I'm rocking, baby.
I didn't watch the skills competition. I did see some of the All-Star farce on Saturday night. Couldn't tell you who won. I mean, it was like 2 minutes into the game, and it's already 4-3. I can't. And Doc Embrick trying to heighten the drama, like these goals are important, like this matters, like a million dollars matters to these people. Come on, it's a farce. Yeah. It's a farce.
Why did you even watch it? I wouldn't have. There had to be something better on.
There really wasn't. I'm in a hotel room in New Hampshire.
Oh.
You got like 18 channels, and there's one of them.
So Emmerich was losing his mind.
Oh, he was so excited, Joe. So excited.
Yeah, well, I watched these skills. I thought the skills was great. I really thought it was good. I mean, the goalie thing kind of, it goes a little draggy with the shootouts on the goalie and who makes the most consecutive saves.
Right.
And, one thing I noticed about that, the familiar faces that used to be in that competition, it's all new guys. It's like Tristan Jarry, and Vasilevsky's been around for a while, but he's in there. You remember the days of Tuukka Rask and Henrik Lundqvist and who else?
Roberto Luongo.
Luongo, Mika Kiprusoff. It's a whole fresh new batch, it seems, yep. In there of, I remember, I don't know, I think the caliber of goaltending there, they had Lionel Richie there, Calgary was in there, and
Lionel Richie.
Yeah, I don't know what the guy's first name really is, but, and Marc-Andre Fleury wasn't there. I mean, it was a little lackluster, and But there were some good saves made in that. But I loved the special appearances. Did you like that?
The special appearances?
By the Blues alumni. The Brett Hull shot.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
During the Shooting Stars. Did Brett Hull eat Bobby Hull?
Well, I saw Brett Hull during the actual game. I didn't see, I didn't see any of the skills competition.
I mean, I'm no Slim Jim myself, but you would think a former athlete, and then Keith Kachuk, what the hell happened to him? Right. He looked like Joe Besser from the freaking Three Stooges.
Joe Besser.
I mean, he really, he's bald, he's big, he's large and in charge. I don't know what this Blues alumni did. Al McInnes still looked good, and he still had that shot over 100 miles per hour.
With a wooden stick, I heard.
Yeah.
Yeah, wow.
So, listen, I thought that Shooting Stars thing, I didn't know what was happening. I thought the 3-on-3 women's game was very entertaining. I got to see, I think, what they tried to accomplish by showcasing the women's hockey. It definitely worked. I definitely had a newfound respect for women's hockey. I mean, I always did, but just some of the talent level, especially the Canadian goaltender, was fantastic. So,
Manon Raoul?
No, it was Bien. I don't know. So she played very well. I'm glad they got rid of that passing thing with those little tiny nets. You remember that? Like they used to have to hit a little net when they had to pass.
Yes, yes.
And that thing where they had to do a relay through those pucks and all that. I thought they made it a lot more fun. And only the NHL can you have your kids down there. You have the two brothers, Matthew and
Brady.
Brady. They're out there. And Patrick Kane getting booed by the St. Louis fans. Then he wins the Shooting Stars competition. It was just fun. And then when Thomas Hertl put on the Justin Bieber mask when he was going against Bennington.
Yes, I did see that.
That was funny. Like gags like that. They're having, it's loosey-goosey. You know, and that's what separates hockey from the other sports. They take themselves too seriously.
Right.
So I enjoyed it. I would not watch the game, though. I don't even know the divisions. I'm still thinking Norris division, Adams division.
Smythe.
You know, Patrick division. And so I don't know the Metropolitan. I know we're in the Metropolitan, but the other ones.
Right.
So anyway, that's where I am with the All-Star game.
All right. So as we told you guys, we're breaking in Studio 2 tonight. We've got some new features. As you can see, there's a little bit different look here. We're gonna try and tweak that banner, that green screen thing that's behind Eddie and I there that you see surrounding our windows. We're gonna see if we can actually read what that says. It's just our logo back there with us superimposed above it. So, and there's a little bit of a new chat room that I'm looking at here. It works much better than the old one, I can tell you that. Costa's still here, though. He's nothing. All these improvements, and we still have Costa.
Well, he comes with the new software.
Right. Yeah. Costa 2.0. It's Costa 2.0. So, and, you know, this is good, though, because we were on Blog Talk Radio, Eddie, for 10 years, and there wasn't one technological improvement in 10 years. It was exactly the same when we left it as it was when we found it.
Oh, all right.
There's Blog Talk Radio calling in right now.
Wow.
So it's nice that, you know, we've only been on this platform for a little less than a year, and we've already got some upgrades. Let's see if this works. This is supposed to look. Oh, there's Howie. Scrap the All-Star game, says Howie. Yes. And that's a new feature that we have here. We can show your comments up on the screen. Scrap the All-Star game.
Oh.
Andre, 90-year-old Keenan is the answer.
Andre Kozlowski was a good one. Yeah, I love
Ryan
it.
Leach says I kind of miss North America versus the world. I like that too.
Yeah, that wasn't bad. That wasn't bad. I'll agree with that.
That was fun. Now I have to ask, as we screw around here with these new features and playing with the chat room and everything, what did you? There was some controversy in the group the other day. Did you piss off Cutter?
No.
Did you upset him?
He was because losing. No, there was no controversy. It was. You know how he gets easily irritated. I was making fun of Jason LaFreniere as a New York Ranger.
Right.
And he got all wiki and crazy because I dared to disparage a guy who had like a nanosecond as a Ranger. Right. And because the guy was not a physical player, I called him Jason LaFreniere. Nothing against gays or anything. He's just, that's what we called him. Back then it was acceptable. It's right. Still acceptable on this show. But back then, that's what I called him. He wasn't physical. And he really wasn't a great player. So anyway, he gets up in a tizzy. So
right.
As he often does.
Yeah.
So I just placated him. I just said, I'm sorry I made you cross. It was kind of sarcastic.
Because you don't want to get on Cutter's bad side because then you know what happens. He uses extra exclamation points. First stage is all caps, and then when he's really pissed, he'll use extra exclamation points. I don't know what happens after the extra exclamation points. I don't think nobody's ever gotten him that mad. Then he blocks you, I guess.
Yeah, he likes to take up a useless cause.
Right.
Every minute of his life.
He should start with his haircut. That's a useless cause right there.
Come on. I think Jason LaFreniere would be very appreciative of Jeff Diamond's taking up for him. Yes. So I see a lot of new people in here. What happened?
I didn't realize Peanut was under my desk here, and I just stepped on him. Sorry, Peanut.
This just then, the cat has died.
The cat's dead. R.I.P. Peanut. Anyway.
I see some new names. Andy Gallegos.
Yes.
Is in here. He's a new dude. John Koz is back. Peter J. Fox. Andre Kozlowski saying hello to the chat room. Just everybody going into the trade everybody mode. Is this what we're still going to talk about? Jonathan Riggs now coming in, RIP Peanut. See, this is pretty cool. I like this.
I like being able to put these comments up here. It's fun. Oh.
You guys should change your profile pictures to like Rangers just for this show. don't fuck with cats. That's true. I think that is an actual movie.
That's the best one.
Yeah.
We can't. Yes. We can't lose Kobe and Peanut at the same time. Yes.
Me and Jim were talking about this before the show.
Yes, we were.
And I'm just going to say it, because this is whatever this is. I don't care. I mean, Kobe Bryant, he's a celebrity. He was a great player. But, I mean, I feel bad for the daughter. Her life was cut early. But, you know, I'm sorry. When these people die, everybody forgets about how flawed they were, and we're all flawed. I don't want somebody sitting up there and saying, you know what, Gag was a great humanitarian, this and that. And, you know, meanwhile, you find out, I've been embezzling millions from the Blueshirt Underground Fund, and you find out all this stuff.
Don't you wish we had millions to embezzle?
Yes, I would. I would like that. It's just overdone. But it's overdone everywhere. I don't know. Celebrity deaths. I don't know. My mom died. Nobody cared about that except our immediate family. Your mom passed away. I don't know. I don't get like verklempt over this whole thing.
Right.
I don't know why. Maybe because I have no intimate experiences with the man. I'll give you for example, because we are kind of testing this thing out, and
Before you go into it, can you move your microphone a little bit closer? Are you able to?
I can get closer.
Okay.
I can get closer to it.
That's better because you're a little. It's a little hollow. You know what I mean? Because you're far away.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
So, my thing is that, oh boy, I forgot my point here.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Here's an example. Two of my favorite musicians have died within like two or three months. One was Rick Ocasek of the Cars, who the Grammys seemed to not get his name right in the memoriam, because I guess they were worried about too much of Nipsey Hussle's lifetime in music. They couldn't concentrate on getting in the memoriam right. Anyway, I met Rick Ocasek several times. I exchanged, we talked for a little bit, not for an extensive amount of time, but I met him. So it's like a personal thing. Now, Neil Peart, from Rush, who I've admired forever since I was in high school as a lyricist and a drummer and all this stuff, I really worshiped him from afar. So when he passed away, I was like, eh. But when Rick Ocasek died, who was a hero of mine, I felt it a little bit more because I actually made a human connection with this guy.
Right.
So to me, Kobe Bryant, he's just like another name. Like, I don't know. I don't have an intimate feeling. I know maybe I'm not empathetic as other people are. I don't know, but it works for me. And I don't see what the whole hysteria is. I mean, it's tragic, the circumstances, how what really went wrong and all that. But I'm really not. I don't want to dive too deep into that personally. I don't. It'll come out what happened, and I don't know. So anyway, that's my take on the whole celebrity death and the mourning and RIP. And I hope Peanut is okay, though.
He's right here. Yes, he's okay. He's still at my feet looking up at me. He's fine.
Wow.
He's fine.
I see that Rock is now in here.
Yep.
Rock
said the new studio looks great. Just getting a look at it in the Facebook group, seeing what everybody else is seeing. It does look good.
All right. I'm enjoying it.
Neil Peart, was he omitted from the Grammys in memoriam?
Apparently to Howie he was, which is ridiculous. So, screw that anyway. It's all rap. I mean, I'm into Lizzo. All right, I like she's all about the body, positive body image, and all that stuff. And what's that other one there? I know you don't even know. I might as well say Feliz Navidad. He was one best.
Is Izzo the big Shirley Hemphill?
Yes, Lizzo. She's the positive body.
It's Lizzo?
Lizzo.
Oh, all right. All right. And good for her.
What's her name? What's the name of the one who won best album, Chris? Billie Eilish.
Oh, Billie Eilish. She's big in this house.
She's 18 years old. What the fuck are we talking about the Grammys? Trade fucking Chris Kreider right now. He looked good in that skating competition. the competition. Trade him down.
Well, Larry Brooks said today that the Rangers will not keep him unless he's signed to a long-term deal. So
what does that mean?
They won't trade him. I mean, they won't keep him unless I guess they're not going to keep him unless he's signed to a long-term deal. They're not going to not trade him and then hope that they could sign him before free agency. You know what I'm saying? If they don't get this done by the trading deadline, he's going to be traded.
Okay. All right. Anne Marie's here. She's rooting for her boy, Sonny Milano. Am I allowed to say that, Anne Marie? I don't know. You got to keep it on the QT. But I would love to see Sonny Milano in a Ranger uniform. He's wearing the wrong red, white, and blue. Or wrong blue, at least.
Speaking of the Columbus Blue Jackets, since you brought it up, a lot of talk of our old pal Torzy there winning the Jack Adams, the way he's got Columbus playing.
Really?
Yeah.
No Bobrovsky? What's their record at? I thought they were struggling. At one point, they were.
They are. Let's see. They are currently, I'll give you their record, 27-16-8.
Whoa! That's pretty good.
8-2 in their last 10. 1 point behind the Islanders.
I don't think the Islanders are going to be able to keep it up. They've been struggling.
How great is it going to be when they fall out of the playoff race, when they don't make the playoffs?
Oh, my God. From your lips to God's ears. Although I don't think they really have the team that could go far in the playoffs anyway. They don't draw penalties. They're not a very I'm not worried about the Islanders.
I'm not worried about them either.
I mean, I'm worried about the Rangers. I'm focused on the Rangers. I'm focused on the people that think that this team is going to storm its way into the playoffs. I'm more concerned about them. So I really don't think it's in the cards this year. Let me ask you this, Jim, and let me ask to the wonderful people in the chat room today. Do you think that this 10-day layoff will help the Rangers in certain cases, like, for instance, Kaapo Kakko, who got a chance to probably go back to his home country? Do you think this 10-day layoff will hurt or hamper the New York Rangers?
I think it's going to help. I think they've got a few young guys probably who aren't used to this long season, could probably use a break. Kaapo Kakko could certainly use a mental break. Let him get back to Finland. Let him eat some of that Finnish food. I don't know what they eat over. What do they eat in Finland? Lutefisk, or is that Sweden? Yeah. It's all the same. Gefilte fish?
They eat some kind of like cured herring or some shit.
All right. Yeah. So it'll be good. He get back to his family. I'm okay with it. I'm all right with this whole bye week. And let me ask you another question. This is something I mentioned when the Rangers played their third game against the Islanders. I don't think I mentioned it on the show. A lot of people complained about, you know, the Rangers hadn't played the Islanders, and then all of a sudden you have these three games in 9 days against them. And I think in the end, when the three – I kind of liked it. I kind of liked them playing all these games so close together. I thought it kind of stirred things up and made for some – for a little bit of nasty hockey at times. I'm all for it. I think they – what do you think about that? I'd like to see them maybe play more of these, you know – you know, I miss the old days of the home and homes and things. They hardly ever do that anymore, although the Rangers will do that this weekend with Detroit, but who the hell cares? They're playing the Grand Rapid Griffins over the just Friday and Saturday. Well, if they don't win Friday night, I'm just going to go crazy.
Yes, because it's going to be like 10 days, and then they lose to the Detroit Red Wings.
Right, right.
On a goal by, I'm trying to think, some wacko, Danny DeKeyser. Well, I think it's actually hurt. Anyway, yeah, I do like a lot of games. I don't know, as a fan, I like it, but as the if you're a player, and I'm sure, hopefully, Panarin will be back in the lineup. I mean, I think that was. Now I don't know what happened. What happened to Ovechkin? He didn't go again, or he did? He couldn't possibly not made it.
I just think he declined to go.
Don't they get fined for that kind of stuff?
Yeah, what does he care? What are they going to get? How much can they fine him? Are they going to fine him? I mean, if they fine him $100,000, big deal.
Right.
He's got that in his couch cushions.
And probably the team picks that up.
Did Vinny Bumba? Is that right, Ryan?
Ryan, are you reporting this?
Ryan reporting that Vinny Bumbats had a hat trick in the AHL All-Star game?
Wow. What was it? One-on-one with someone?
Oh, that's just wrong.
Well, they better bring him up then. If this guy is so good, you bring up Finny Bumbats.
I'm bringing that. What's the matter, you? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad. It's a nicer place. Ah, shut up for your face.
See?
Wow, that's a classic.
Joe Ponce, I think, was that guy's name? Something like that?
Yeah. The event of the Ponce. Apparently, he did not score a hat trick. Ryan Leach was falsely reporting that. I think so. So anyway, so we go into this. I guess this is the second half of the season. I already passed the halfway mark. I don't really know what to say except I guess I could just pose some questions to everybody, including you. What do you see the future for David Quinn? If you could go into your crystal balls, if you could, not in your pants and get your balls, but your crystal balls, what do you think is the future for this guy? Like, I'll let you guys answer, and I'll give you my thoughts.
Well, I'm gonna, just from what I've been reading, and from what's going on in Hartford. I can't help but think that David Quinn might want to be looking over his shoulder a little bit at this. What is it? Keith Knobloch, the coach in Hartford. Is that his name? Not Chuck. It's Knobloch.
Yeah, Knobloch.
Because he's doing a hell of a job with Hartford. Players love playing for him. He's a real teaching coach. You know, I read a really good article about him. I think it was written by Vince Mercogliano, or whatever, however you say his name, writes for Lohud. But you know, the other thing is that this guy in Hartford, this was JD's handpicked guy for Hartford. So you know, with all of this investment in the future, I don't think Quinn's in any danger of going anywhere at the end of this season. I just can't see how you can. Yeah, I don't see how you could fairly judge these two seasons. I think there's been some good things, and I think there's been some head-scratching things. But, you know, look, every coach they've ever had has done head-scratching moves. So I don't think he's in any danger anytime soon. But I do think he's going to be looking over his shoulder a little bit at this guy in Hartford. Because, like I said, this is JD's guy, and this is JD's team now. You know, JD is the president. Yep. He's going to, you know. So.
I think it's going to depend on whether the Rangers really make some progress next year and make the playoffs.
Right.
They make the playoffs next year, I think he stays. But if they don't make the playoffs and it's the same thing it was this year, I think he's going to be gone.
Well, I think even more than that, I think this team has to, and I know we're already talking about next season, but whatever, got to talk about something. I think next year, I think this team has got to come out and be able to sustain playing good hockey. You can't keep winning two games in a row, and then losing a game, winning a game, losing two in a row, winning a game. You know, they have to put some sustained runs together to show improvement.
Okay, Andre Kozlowski says he's not getting fired and he will coach through next season after, you know, his team is not making playoffs this year or next. Andre, you're in for the long haul rebuild. I don't know. This team is, will be 1 year older, more experienced. Then you got Hanks last year. He might not even see a game next year. Georgiev,
because
he's traded and everything.
Savoy, to answer your question, I've had trouble getting the audio from the last two shows, which is why those have not been on iTunes. And within the next couple of weeks, we are going to be transitioning over to Podbean, which will upload our audio to iTunes and Spotify and every place else. So just kind of bear with us. It'll be there. We'll get the shows will come back to iTunes. I promise. We're in a little bit of a transitional here.
Yes, we're transitioning.
Transitioning. Yes, we're transitioning.
And it's just Stephen Wallman says, you know, and Rock, which I've been saying as well, they don't go on a winning streak. You can't go a whole season without going at least two winning streaks. They haven't got on one. They haven't reeled off like six wins, seven wins, you know, eight undefeated, you know, eight with the. So the Rangers, they got to get it together here.
Right. What I mean, like, you know, one of those like eight out of the last 10, you know, six out of the last seven. You know, I'd settle for four out of five at this point, I think.
Well, you're not going to make the playoffs if you don't go on any winning streak. And every time you put Henrik in there, the winning streak goes kaput.
And I fully expect, I know no announcement's been made yet. It's only Tuesday, but I fully expect Henrik Lundqvist to play Friday night when I go to the game.
He usually plays against Detroit.
But I just figured that he hasn't played, I think it's since January 9th, I want to say. I just
Happy
can't.
Happy New Year.
Coming back off this long break, I have a feeling he'll play Friday night. And quite honestly, I'm okay with that because it might be the last time I ever see him. And having always seen the Rangers on the road the last, you know, for most of his career, I don't get to see him very much. I've seen Steve Valiquette more times than I care to remember. And I think I saw Alex Auld. I've seen Talbot. Very little. I think I saw Marty Biron once and Ronta once. Very few times have I seen Lundqvist because, you know, they didn't like to, they would always play him on the, play him at home and try and save the road games for when the backups would play. But I fully expect him to play Friday night. I'd be very surprised if he doesn't. And then one of the commies will play Saturday night in Detroit.
Well, I just think that you can't start the season of the second half of the season post All-Star break better than a home and home with the Detroit Red Wings. You got to hit the ground running against these teams,
right?
And the reason yes, we're a young team, and I see you guys talking about that, but we have Artemi Panarin. This guy makes everybody better, and he's a superstar. We have a bona fide superstar.
Mika, that's Artemi Panarin.
Thank you, Sam.
Thank you, Sam.
Sam making his debut in Studio 2. He sounds just as good.
Yes.
Yes, John. Yes, Sam will be very excited to see Jimmy Howard. He loves Jimmy Howard. Oh, Joe, he loves playing at the Garden, Joe. He loves it. Grew up a Ranger fan, Joe. Mike Richter was his favorite.
Jimmy Howard kills the Rangers.
Not the last time they played.
No, his play has come down a bit. It was kind of like Cam Ward used to kill the Rangers until he started to. His play went down. No. These goalies, when they lose it fast. let's see. What else we got? A lot of people were talking about Quinn will fill out his contract. How many years is he signed for? Three? I don't know.
Jimmy Howard is 10-4 lifetime against the Rangers with a 1.9 goals against and a 944 save percentage.
Wow.
And
sick.
That is his, let me see. That looks like quick scan. That is his best save percentage against any team in the league.
What's
and that is his best, that is his best goals against any team in the league. But what I
about
don't
Carter Hutton. What's Carter Hutton's lifetime? Let's think of every Ranger killer goalie out there.
Actually, I just want to look at something really quick.
Jimmy Howard.
No, I'm just Jimmy Howard. Okay, one game against the Rangers this year gave up four goals.
Yeah, they got to him.
He's 0-1 this year. Last year he was, let me see, he was 3-0 against the Rangers with a 1.919 goals against and a 944 save percentage. Oh, Joe, he loves it here at Madison Square Garden, Joe. Wow, it's impressive. Carter Hutton? Barbara Hutton?
Barbara Hutton, Carter Hutton. Anybody else got some Ranger killers that are still in the league?
It's stat night on the BSU show. Who's got what? Let's see. Splits. And we have to go to career. And hockeyreference.com is one of the best websites in existence, by the way. Carter Hutton's only 4-2 against the Rangers lifetime. Right, with a 928 save percentage and a 2.19 goals against.
Jonathan Riggs.
Wow.
Offers Carter, Ben Bishop.
Carter Hutton against the Buffalo Sabres. Listen to this. He is 5-0 lifetime against the Buffalo Sabres with a 963 save percentage and a 0.98 goals against.
Well, that's why he's on them. Is he on Buffalo now?
Is he on Buffalo now? I couldn't think even. So. Well, yeah, but he's played 5 games against them.
No,
He was on Buffalo. Yeah, right.
This guy said you got to get him a
right lifetime, but he's pretty good. Yeah, I guess that's why they got him, right?
How about Big Ben Bishop?
Ben Bishop.
Beat the Bishop.
Ben Bishop.
Beat the Bishop, as I always say.
Ben Bishop. Let's see. Splits career. Ben Bishop is 11-2 against the New York Rangers.
Ooh!
With a 9.36 save percentage and a 1.77 goals against.
Oh,
and I'm not sure if that includes his playoff. Nope, that's just regular season.
People want to know a Halak. Yaroslav Halak.
The Halak Ness monster.
Oh, all right,
let's see.
Good.
He is his career. He is. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on here. Oh, all right. He is 21-8 with a 2.48 goals against and a 924 save percentage.
That's a great winning percentage.
That's pretty impressive.
Pretty impressive.
Pretty impressive.
And then finally, Stephen Wallman. Hope you're not related to Susan. If so, my condolences. Thomas, the Grice is wrong. He was with Pittsburgh with the Islanders. It's probably decent.
Let's see. Splits. Come in. And hold on, career. Thomas Grice is 5-0 with a 928 save percentage and a 2.55 lifetime goals against.
Wow! So you guys are right on with all your picks.
Yep.
Very good. Very good. That's why he. What Rocco about Schneider?
Corey Schneider.
Corey Schneider. I thought he was talking about Matthew Schneider.
All right, Corey. Wow. Corey Schneider is, let's see, career. Corey Schneider is terrible. 6-8 with a 9.14 save percentage and a 2.62 goals against.
Wow, Rocco. So give him the wah, wah, wah. If you could find it there on that. For the next.
Joe Garcia wants to know about Ron Hextall. All right, last one. Ron Hextall.
Carey Price, I would like to know too.
Oh, you want to know Carey Price? All right, hold on.
They beat Ron Hextall like a bad dog in that playoff series in '94. Is that him that they sent to back it?
Ron Hextall, he was terrible. He was 17-22 against the Rangers with an 8.91 save percentage and 3.27 goals against.
That's horrible, Mike. Horrible.
It's terrible. He put up actually some of the worst numbers he put up against any NHL team were against the Rangers. Who was the other one you asked about? Carey Price. Carey Price splits career. Carey Price 19-8-1 against the Rangers. With a 9.28 save percentage and a 2.17 goals against.
Not in the playoffs, though. Is that playoffs included or no?
No, it's just regular season.
Okay. We seem to find a way to get the puck, even if we have to Chris Kreider to run into him to get the puck behind him in the playoffs. Pecorini, I don't know, Rocco. I don't think we're going to give you a second chance after that terrible, terrible.
Pecorini, what? How many times did they play Pecorini? Like five times, maybe?
Maybe. I just remember the guys they can't get it past.
If you insist. Here, 8 games against the Rangers. He's 4-3 with a 9-1-0 and a 2.50 goals against.
That's nothing.
Nothing.
How about Cam Ward?
Strike two, Rocco.
Andre Kozlowski wants to know about Marc-Andre Fleury. We're going to go through every goaltender that ever played in the
ever played. when do we get to Bob Sauve?
Gilles Meloche. Give me Gilles Meloche's splits.
Cam Ward is 13-17 against the Rangers with a 9.17 save percentage and a 2.58 goals against.
Oh, yeah. I have to take Craig, Mr. Anderson was pretty good against the Rangers. Cam Talbot. All right. Now it's getting silly. Now you guys are getting silly. What was Gilles Meloche?
Gilles Meloche was 5-6 with 5 ties and 8.86 save percentage and a 3.65 goals against. Gilles Meloche, he only had a save percentage over 900 against like 2 teams in the entire league. He was terrible, Mikey. He was terrible, Mikey.
It's terrible, Mike. I mean, the guy is a professional goalie, and he's horrible. But that was a different time, too. They wore, like, you know, Milik pants. They didn't look built like a RoboCop.
Bob Sauve was 5-7 with an 8.58 save percentage and a 3.87 goals against.
But you know what? You know, you really go back? Look up Dan Bouchard. Dan Bouchard, I guarantee, had sick numbers against the New York Rangers. Sick!
Former Atlanta Flame, right? Dan Bouchard.
And Nordique. God bless.
Let's see. Dan Bouchard, 9-6. With a save percentage of 8.76 and a goals against of 3.94. He must have shut the Rangers out once, and you just happened to watch that game.
It was a killer. I think, you know what, affected there was an 8-8 tie that he was involved with, which might have ruined that against the Rangers. Okay. Because they used to get killed by the Flames. I mean, the Rangers' record against the Flames was, when they were in Atlanta, it was bad. All right, so now that we take the trip down memory lane, we can. What else you want to talk about in this Fakakta show?
Yeah. Well, we do have a couple of guests waiting. We can talk to them in a second. Yeah. Tomorrow night we are going to test this out on YouTube. I will be posting the link in the group. And you can join us on YouTube. As far as I know, you can chat along there too. And I don't know. Tomorrow night we'll run through the Western Conference, so the Campbell Conference goaltenders, how they did against the Grant Fuhr and Andy Moog and who else? Kirk McLean. We'll go through his numbers and Roji Vachon.
How do you like that? There was no Jeremy Roenick at this All-Star guy. He's still in, what is he, in the cancel culture? Get rid of him, too?
I guess so. Ron Tugnutt.
Oh.
Another name. Oh, they're just pulling everybody out here.
Ron Tugnutt made like 58 saves or 60 saves in a game. He may have a record for most saves in a game.
Was that a regular season game or was that a playoff game that he did that?
Don't know. Remember.
Okay. All right.
Now on the YouTube thing, let me ask you: is it, we're going to go? It's going to be on our Blue Shirt Underground channel. We have a setup for that.
I don't know yet how tomorrow night's show will work. I'm hoping that yes, we. I mean, it would make sense for us to be on our Blue Shirt Underground channel.
Okay, why don't you put up BJ Renzo's question? BJ Renzo asked, does anyone think we should trade for Columbus? Now, isn't Josh Anderson the one who had a really great year last year and is doing nothing this year? Is this the player in question? No, I don't think we should get Josh Anderson at this point. I think he may have just had a good year. If this is the player I'm thinking about, no, so that would be my.
He had 27 goals last year. This year he has one goal and three assists in 26 games.
Yeah. I think, you know, he could be a one-hit wonder. We don't know. The Rangers.
Tim Shevelday. My goodness.
Yeah. Michael Smith, Mike Liut.
Mike Liut. What about Mike Palmateer? Here's another good name for you.
Yeah. No one with stone hands. Really, Josh Anderson? He had 27 goals, though. But I don't know. Let me see what this Josh Anderson. Take a look at it. I feel like we're doing more of a computer-based show than we usually do. Like a free-form chat or looking up stats and, you know.
Well, it's the off week. We're filling time.
Yeah, I would check it out, the new software. So if you're tuning in for the first time, it usually doesn't work like this. Josh Anderson right now is a healthy scratch for – oh, he's injured right now, Josh Anderson. So he's on IR. He's expected to miss 4 to 6 weeks, so I don't think we should get – I mean, this was a while ago.
Cross him off the list.
Yeah, Anderson's had a terribly difficult season. Nah, I don't think I'm going to take a flyer on Josh Anderson.
Right.
At this point.
All right, let's talk to Costa real quick. We'll talk to Connor real quick, and we'll wrap this up. We seem to be getting the hang of this new studio, so. We can. This was going to be a short thing anyway. So,
right. Whoa!
Whoa!
His punum is right there, right there.
What's up, Costa?
Oh, no one. Oh, there he is.
All there right. He is.
What's up, gentlemen?
Not much. The same old crapola.
Same old Malachi is.
Did you watch the All-Star Skills?
Yeah, right.
You won't watch the Skills?
I was too busy washing my hair. Thank you.
Oh, looks good. Looks good. So you didn't watch the Skills. You didn't watch any part of the weekend.
It's a glorified exhibition.
Okay. Andre Kozlowski is now chimed in. He says, trade Costa. I would not trade Costa. He's wearing his idiot box shirt. Andy Gallego says, yikes. I love the fact that the live thing's being posted. Hey, listen, this is a show that is, you know, Alex says you spend your heart on running on this team. This is you got it.
I'm going to get it now. Now I'm going to get the business. Give me these fucking mental midgets.
Well, listen, you're kind of a star. The show. I've talked to several times up there. He knows. Look. The braggadocio. Yes, look at him. He's quaffing his hair. He's throwing his hair back. Did Costa use the same shampoo as Hank?
Yes, I do, as a matter of fact.
Ah, very good, very good, very good. So, Costa, you didn't watch the All-Star game. What do you have to bring to the show today? Besides the
where do you think Kreider's going to land?
Well, let me ask Boston. You this. Do you think there's any chance that he signs a long-term deal with the Rangers? I don't think so either.
I wouldn't sign him anyways.
He's been hot, though. He's one of the hottest players right now. He's hey, streaky.
Remember, sell high, my friend. Sell high.
That's true. And I think he benefits a lot. They all benefit from playing with Panarin. So, and I think we've kind of seen. And now, listen, I know there are
I think it's St. Louis. Because like I mentioned before, what's his name is hurt. He's not going to be. He won't be back until the playoffs, if that.
Tarasenko.
What's his name?
Tarasenko.
Yeah, he ain't going to be back until the playoffs, if that. So, you know.
Okay. So you say St. Louis, you say Boston. I'll take a. He winds up on the Avalanche. I don't know why.
I could see that too. It's going to be Boston, St. Louis, or Colorado.
I'm just, you know.
Would he accept the trade to Edmonton?
Well, hasn't he been nicked nicks on going to Canada? That's been rumored.
A, they're a playoff team, and two,
the money.
Wouldn't want to play with friggin' Connor McDavid.
I'd love to play with Connor McDavid.
Or worst case, Ryan Leon Hopkins.
Oh, Leon Draisaitl.
And them too.
The Draisaitl's sick. McDavid's even sicker. No, I mean, but it may come down to your almighty dollar. You know, do you want to play in Canada?
Well, it'll be a rental. If he goes to Edmonton, it'll be a rental anyways.
That's true. It's all about the cash.
Any of the other three teams, it'll be a rental anyways.
Do you think the Rangers will absorb some of that contract? Oh, that's not that big anyway. What is it, $4 or $5 million? $5 million?
If they give us something substantial, we might have to eat some money. Who knows?
Stephen Wallman talks about Georgiev. He says he's going to Toronto. What am I missing here? Is Frederik Andersen on the outs? I thought he's their guy. Why do they need a backup goaltender?
I don't think they're sold on Andersen, and I don't think I forget who his backup is. His backup that Hutchinson.
Yes, the guy from NXS. Michael
yeah, Hutchinson. Right. He's still hanging around.
Yeah, I could see not having a capable backup, but they.
Yeah, but they don't have anything.
But what are they going to give?
Exactly, they have nothing. They have guts.
Why would you go to Toronto? I don't know.
They don't have any tradable assets in Toronto.
Why don't we trade them to Arizona? I mean, they already got Antti Raanta. Don't we trade with Arizona every freaking week? I mean, can't we fix them again?
Are they a playoff team?
I don't know.
Is Arizona a playoff team?
Don't they have that advanced statistics wacko leading their GM is some advanced statistics nut job or their president that's going to set them into the future?
Yeah, Arizona right now is in the playoff picture. They are seventh overall in the conference.
Chris Kreider's going to Arizona for Derek Stepan.
Go out there and play with Kessel, right?
They need some speed. They got some good guys. That Christian Dvorak's pretty decent. You always got on defense. You've got Oliver Ekman-Larsson.
Now, what's the name hurt again? Is Raanta hurt again?
No, Raanta is going, I think, played last night, I think, if Phoenix played. He was scheduled to start. Lanthi Raanta. Raanta Claus, yes. Don't we really miss that guy? I mean, we worship these guys when they're here, but really, the nothings. Cam Talbot turned out to be terrible. I mean,
they got the three goalie system.
And Georgiev. Jim doesn't feel that Georgiev is a starter in this league, right, Jim?
I'm just not sure he's. I don't think he's a 60. A 60 start guy, and I don't see him as a guy that's going to get hot for you in April, and steal you a couple of games in a round. You know what I mean?
Post Jonathan Riggs' statement on that. They hired some advanced stats there. Shout out to my people at HF.
By the way, Cam Talbot's numbers, you say he's terrible. His numbers are better than Hank's. Just saying.
Really?
Well, who's he playing with? Who's he playing for?
He's playing for Calgary.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
What do you think? Calgary is a bunch of bums?
Well, they fired their coach, didn't they, early this season? The great Bill Peters? Did he get fired?
I believe so.
Yeah. They've had been struggling a bit, I think. But,
Calgary's a playoff team, too.
They're 7 points better than the Rangers.
That's not good.
Right.
So, Cam Talbot told it.
7 points better than the Rangers with two games in hand. Get out of here with this Calgary, not a bunch of people. Get out of here touting the great Flames team. Yeah, he's looking it up. He doesn't believe me. Look how furrowed his brow is right now.
Oh, Edmonton, the Pacific Division. That's
you gotta face Connor McDavid every other night.
That's anyone's division, the Pacific Division. That's anybody's division. It's like a 5-way tie for like first place. Yeah.
I think we're done with giving Tampa. Not Steve Yzerman is not affiliated with Tampa. I think we're done with giving them everything. And
maybe as a UFA, he might go to Tampa, but not as a trade partner. Now,
like I said on last week's show, I want a colossal throttling of the team that we traded to. I want us to get picks, players. Hold them over the coals, just like they did to us for years and years and years. I read the most desired players. He's number one.
Wouldn't you say we fleeced Boston with the Nash deal?
Definitely. That was stupid on their part because they knew what they were getting—a non-playoff performer. Why are you giving away that much?
He's going to retire next season.
Yeah, he became concussion boy, and he had to retire. Duh! It was dumb, man. I mean, it's dumber than the Scott Gomez for Ryan McDonough deal. I mean,
And of course, my boy Ryan Strome is my boy.
Ryan Spooner. Was the female hockey player that was named Spooner, was she related to Ryan? Because she probably's got more chance of making the NHL than Ryan does. So, I don't know. I think people are going to be, you know how it gets. These teams need to give their fan bases, they got to get them jazzed at the deadline. So they've got
I'm sure we'll easily get a one out of for at least a one for Kreider. At least a one.
Yes. And more. Yeah, if he goes to Boston, I want Patrice Bergeron, Torrey Krug, Charlie McAvoy. Give us that McAvoy kid. He ain't doing that great.
I'd take Charlie McAvoy on his team in a heartbeat.
What's he got, one goal?
Who cares?
But he's too much of a stud, that guy. I mean, it's not going to they're not gonna get that crazy. Because Boston really doesn't need too much. Yeah. You need a team that really needs – that's going to think, like, this guy's going to be a difference maker in our team. So when you think about where he's going to go, Boston, he's a nice fit for them. And he gives them that extra oomph. Imagine he's on that team, and you got to worry about Marshawn. Even Sam is getting excited.
All right, Costa.
I got one last question.
Yes.
When Seattle finally comes to the league, do you think they're going to have to realign the conferences or whatever?
I haven't given one thought.
Yeah, going to put the Islanders in the West.
I'll bet you they're going to go to an NFL format. Four divisions in the East and four in the West. That wouldn't shock me.
Well, you've been right about eight defensemen. You'll be right again with the Magna Costa. But, yeah, my friend, we'll see what happens. But right now, because what's going on now with the New York Rangers and Seattle, we'll worry about later. All right, Costa, take care.
Bye, Costa. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I'll punch it out, Maverick.
There he goes. To bring Connor right in. We're getting right to it. We're rapid fire here. We're going to wrap this up. What's up, Connor?
Evening, boys.
You sound good.
Thank you.
See, yeah. Studio 2 is good. It looks good on people.
Yeah, the quality of the audio is much better, I think.
I believe so.
Okay. Very good.
All right, Connor, what's on your mind?
Thanks for calling, Connor.
Yeah, I'm surprised that no one suggested maybe Pittsburgh would go for Kreider because we can get something for him. I mean, obviously it would be a nightmare seeing him in bronze and black, but, you know, I mean, it was the same thing for every player we trade away, you know. Thank you for your service. Goodbye.
Yeah, we move on. I mean, you know, listen, I watched Thomas Asher burn us like every freaking uniform he played with. He played with Pittsburgh, with Detroit, you know.
What do the Penguins have that we want?
Although we didn't trade him. What do the Penguins have?
They have
goalie, Tristan Jarry. We want another goaltender. We could start a four-goalie rotation over here.
Four-goalie rotation.
For a total of $9 million.
I don't know. I haven't really looked into what Pittsburgh might have. I don't know what they're as a rental. But I think it raises a good point. They need a little bit of a oomph from, a little bit of offensive oomph. Put a bit more of Crosby's back finally. They've been getting, Malkin's been good, and but they have another guy too that's doing pretty well, and
Patrick Brown.
Oh God,
Patrick Brown, is that Patrick Brown?
Wow, is that Patrick Brown? So they have they could use it.
I mean, I don't really care where we send him. I just want a first round pick back. And, you know, that's not too hard to offer, especially considering Chris Kreider's at his peak right now.
Andre Kozlowski is reporting that Pittsburgh has the worst prospect pool in NHL.
Oh.
That's from Andre Kozlowski. He's reported a lot of things during this show.
Yes.
I like that.
Appreciated.
Yes. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know where it's going to wind up, but I think you're right. You hit the nail on the head. First round pick plus.
There you go.
Right.
There you go. And as for what you were talking about with Toronto, I mean, you can't really go with one goalie. That's why Cam Talbot didn't work in Edmonton, was because he was just straight up exhausted. So I get the feeling that's the same thing with Freddie Anderson in Toronto. Which means they'll probably they're more likely to pay above market value for someone like Gorgiev, who's a reliable backup.
Yeah, I mean, in recent years, you've seen two goalies play the playoffs. We had Matt Murray and Marc-Andre Fleury 1 year. We've Binnington, and I think, who was it, Elliott? I don't know who it was last year.
Jake Allen.
They split time. So it's become more of a thing, but I'm more of a fan of the one goalie system in the playoffs. You ride or die with that goalie. And hey, listen, it's good to have options. It's good to have options.
Yeah. I mean, the Rangers, I know we're not where we were a year ago or 2 years ago, but I still wouldn't mind being sellers at the deadline because we have our prospects and we have people to build around, but we can still get a good return.
Right. And the Rangers are not done with their rebuild. They have to keep getting that minor league system. It's made some big strides this year. And I've got to keep that talent pool's just got to keep coming because a lot of these guys don't make it. Look at Elias Anderson, who, by the way, did you see got he's being allowed to play in Sweden, I think, now. The Rangers have given him permission.
Oh, wow. He got loaned out, right?
Yeah. So you have guys that just don't make it. So you got to keep accumulating these picks. It's right. A hard thing, you know, prospects and stuff. And some of them don't pan out. So collect.
Let me just say, though, before I get off, that Studio 2 was more – this studio was more successful than Elias Anderson's reboot, the first and the second.
Yes. Now he's just – we're going to give him the boot. All right. Well, listen, I hope the kid would have done better, but it's dead and gone now. So we must press on. We must move on. We must succeed where others have failed, as I've said many times.
Yes.
Yes.
All right, Connor, have a good night. We're gonna say goodbye to you. And
signing off.
We're going to sign off because we're going to do a show tomorrow. So we got to think of things to talk about tomorrow.
Tomorrow night, we're going to cover the Campbell Conference goaltender's lifetime versus the Rangers. All right, Connor, we'll talk to you later.
Talk to you later. Look up Antti Raanta against the Rangers.
No.
No.
See ya.
He only played like 8 games in the NHL before he came to the Rangers or something.
Right. All right. Later, Connor.
Later.
There you go.
All right. Cutter can't get into Studio 2. He's being denied.
Studio 2 is built in with an artificial intelligence that keeps out Cutter, which benefits us all.
Who has no artificial intelligence?
Oh,
it's terrible. Isn't that terrible? All right. I'm going to set the show up for we'll see you tomorrow night. We're going to try this YouTube thing and see how it goes. 7:30. I'll post the information in the group probably not till tomorrow. And we'll see how it goes.
All right.
All right. So Studio 2, a successful first run. That will wrap up this week's edition of the Blue Shirt Underground Show with Jim and Eddie. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Nice big crowd. A lot of fun. Eddie, always a pleasure. We'll do this again tomorrow.
Yeah, man. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
We love you. Good night, everybody.